Hello there, folks. My name is Manyura Queen. Today, we are taking a look at the Uzima Borehole drilling system, and we are going specifically to the table design. Tables can either be informative and also they can be computational. When I talk about informative tables, this is what I mean. A table can hold information that is not going to be very important to the client, but very, very important to you as a database keeper. And in this way, you can keep information about the client, that is the ID, the name, the address, the location, and also the telephone number in case you want to contact the client. When we move on to computative tables, you can keep information such as the type of drill, the fees charged, that is the survey fee. You can also talk about the total amount. All that information, you're going to do some calculation on it so that you end up with some results at the end. So when you talk about tables, keep in mind we are talking about the two information, the two types of data that you're going to store inside the tables. Very crucial. So before we begin building our tables in the Uzima borehole drilling system, I want you to be aware that we have to keep informative data and also computational data that is going to help you design your tables much more efficient. Another thing that you're supposed to keep in mind is how your tables are going to be related to other tables. Remember, you cannot keep all information under one table. You need information on one table and others on other tables, and then relating the two tables will give you a relational database. So keep that in mind and then we shall move on. From the question booklet that you have in your hands, you read through it and you'll understand that all clients must be registered before receiving any services from the Uzima company. Now, with that information, you already know that you have the first table, which is going to contain the information about the client. That table is going to contain records such as the ID of the client, the name, the telephone number, the address, and the location where he wants the services to be delivered to. The most important thing about that table is that each client should have a unique ID, and in the access database, that ID is going to be automatically generated. You don't have to do anything about it. Another table which is going to be very, very important is the table that is going to contain all the records of the services which have been rendered out to clients. This table, we are going to name it service table, and remember, when you are giving names to your tables, it is very, very much crucial to give TBL as the last name to your table. Whatever name you are going to decide, you end it with TBL. Whether it is a form, you end it with FRM, meaning form. That way, it is going to be very easy for you to differentiate between tables, forms, and queries in Microsoft Access. From the question paper, you have several tables which have been given to you. Those tables include the survey table, the drilling services table, also the height or the depth table, it is given there. We have other tables that you're going to design yourself, which are going to be important in designing your system. These tables will include the plumbing table, because you've been told plumbing services will be rendered with some information, which I'm going to give later. We also have the pump table and also the pipes table. The pipes table will contain all the types of pipes which are available in the world. The most important tables are going to be the clients table and also the services rendered table. The services rendered table is going to contain the services that were rendered to the clients. And also, the table clients is going to contain information about the clients. Remember earlier I talked about tables being related. Now, the services rendered table and also the clients table, we have to relate the two tables, because in the services offered table, we cannot have the name of the client in that particular table and also the location and the address or the telephone number in such table. So because of that, we have to relate the services offered table to the client's table so that every client who receives services from the company is registered and known. Also, This will prevent the table services from receiving more than enough information. We cannot be having repetitive work done in the services table. What I mean by this is that we cannot have the same information repeated. That is why we have relationships between the two tables. That way, the information about the client cannot be repeated in the services TBL. That is all for today. If you enjoyed the video, make sure you give it a like and also subscribe for more videos to come soon.